Hello students. So this is the continued part of alternating current topic. In the last class we were discussing about the AC applied to a resistor independently and AC applied to a capacitor and AC applied to the inductor. And we were discussing, so what would be the phase difference? What's the phase difference between the current and voltage in the three separate cases? And now we are having a case, there are three devices, inductor, capacitor and the resistor, and all these three are connected in series. Okay, this is called series LCR circuit. For this series LCR circuit, we have connected an AC source. So this is the circuit diagram. We have connected the AC source, okay, AC source, and its voltage V is equal to V naught into sin omega t. So its value is V equal to V naught into sin omega t. So LCR, they are in series, and we have connected the AC source. Okay, so here and we know the series combination is also called as a voltage divider. Is also called as voltage divider. So the total voltage V is divided into three parts. So the voltage through the inductor, is called VL. Okay, I can write it as the current through the inductor, and its opposition, the opposition offered by the inductor is called inductive reactance. In the same way, I can write the VC. So the potential difference across the capacitor is equal to current in the capacitor and the capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance means its opposition. Okay, opposition offered by the capacitor into its current, that will give the voltage across that capacitor. In the same way, the voltage across the resistor is equal to R into R. Voltage across the resistor is R into R. Is it? Okay. VL, C, R. So VL, VC and VR are the potential differences across inductor, capacitor and resistor. And we know in the series combination, the current through the each component is same. So that's why II is same. You can't write like a IL, IC and IR. Okay, it is same. Though that why I written only the I. Is it? Okay, if you represent the same thing, in our phasor diagram, so I write the current is along x-axis. Okay, so we know in case of AC, in case of inductor, the current lags behind. The current lags behind the voltage. Means if I write the current here, so I should write voltage in the forward direction and VL by an angle, pi by 2. So I illi dandre. So idr mungade eshtu enirbeka voltage irbeka, because I lags behind id hindulidada, yes angle hindulidada 90 degree hindulidada. So adakke na en madbeka, I should draw the voltage here. This is the VL. Okay, and the second one, in case of capacitor, I leads the voltage, current leads the voltage, its symbol is VC, by angle again 90 degree. So in case of capacitor, the current leads the voltage, means current voltage ginta 90 degree mundu irutada. Hangadre nan voltage en madbeka illi draw madbekri. I call this is VC. Okay, in case of resistor, so what's the phase difference between the current and voltage in case of resistor? So current and voltage both will be in the same phase in case of a resistor. Okay, so current and voltage are in, so for the voltage in the resistor I call VR, are in same phase. Okay, so here I draw the VR. This is VR. VR and I are along x-axis. VL is positive Y because the current is lagging, and VC is in negative Y because the current is leading. Is it clear? Okay, so in phasor diagram, each quantity are like a vectors. Okay, so each quantity is represented by a rotating vector. That's why it is phase diagram. So we should get the resultant of VL, VC and VR. So that will be the vectorial result. Okay, so we should add them as per the vector algebra. Right, so first in mind, VL, VC, VR. You more sarisidakshana V aagtada. How da? So more sarisidakshana V aagtada. Now in mind, first ivaga VL mathe VC the result takaladu. VL, VC result takaladu. So adhine in mind, so total edakke R ge add madada. So we can write like V is equal to VL plus VC plus VR. First get the resultant of these two. Okay, first write so V equal to VL, VC, VR. So first you should take the resultant of these two. Okay, so I call that as a V dash. Okay, and add that result to the R. So with that you can get the total voltage. Is it? Okay, so we can write like V is equal to, okay, first the result of VL and VC. The result of VL and VC is equal to VL minus VC. This is VL minus VC. So why I have written VL minus VC? See this diagram. VL is in upward direction and VC is in downward direction. And see, so for the current, voltage is 90 degree forward. Okay, and in case of inductor, voltage 90 degree mundu adare. In case of capacitor, voltage 90 degree in dada. So we are in angle in 180, means they are in opposite direction. So once one term should be positive, another term must be the negative. Okay, here I take a case that is VL is greater than VC. VL is greater than VC. Okay, so that's why the result of these two is VL minus VC, and that will be along the VL. That will be along the VL. Yav dodd vector dana adar guntana resultant direction irutada. So I'll write VL minus VC. This is VL minus VC, this one. Is it? Okay, so this is VL minus VC. Then result of VL minus VC and VR. VL minus VC and VR is. Iva again madbeka? Resultant of VL minus VC, VL of VC, this is VL minus VC, and there is one more VR. So I draw a parallelogram here. Okay, so I can write like this. So this is the total V now. I'll give the name, this is O, okay, and this is A, and this is the B, O, A, B, right? Okay, so this is the resultant vector. Next, I can write like a OB square is equal to OA square plus AB square. Okay, OA square is equal to OB square equal to OA square plus AB square. Or I can write under root AB, OB equal to. Okay, this hypotenuse side is equal to OA plus AB under root. Okay, so OB is the total voltage and OA is along x axis, this is VR plus AB. So this AB is equal to this one. So this is nothing but VL minus VC. Okay, V square, OA square, AB square. And this is VL minus VC whole square. Okay, and the next step, substitute the values of VR, VL, VC. So for VR, this is I square, R square. Plus, this is I into XL minus I into XC whole square. Okay, so here I square is common term, and here also, if I take out of the bracket, I square will be the common. So take it out, this will be I. Into bracket, the remaining term is R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So this is V. Okay, then V by I is equal to root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. XL minus XC whole square. Okay, so then was a V is a total voltage. Was I, this is the current. Okay, so you can't say voltage by R is a resistance, which is only in case of the resistor, in case of conductor. Here we are studying the AC. So this is like a total voltage in the LCR circuit divided by total current in that LCR circuit. For this we give a new name, the entire opposition. So total voltage over total current will give the opposition. Okay, voltage by current is the opposition. Total voltage by total current is the total opposition offered by the entire LCR circuit. So for that we give a name, impedance. We call it as a impedance, and its symbol is a Z. Its symbol is a Z. So total voltage divided by total current will give you the impedance. So we get one more question. What do you mean by impedance? Impedance is the opposition. Is the opposition offered by the LCR circuit? Is the opposition offered by the series LCR circuit to the flow of AC in it? Okay, LCR circuit nalli AC flow agbekadre yen opposition barlatitta aa total opposition ge nen kerithevi nava impedance antava. That opposition may be by the resistor, that opposition may be by the inductor, that opposition may be by the capacitor. So combinedly we call it as a impedance. Okay, so instead of writing V by I, now I'll write the symbol Z, which is the impedance. Okay, next up, Z is equal to under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square. R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So this becomes the final equation for impedance of a series LCR circuit. Next, I want to get what's the current in that circuit. What's the value of current in that circuit? So then current in the circuit. I is equal to V divided by opposition. So I'll write it as I is equal to V divided by under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square. This is the second result. Okay, this is the first result. Okay, impedance and current. We have given the voltage to series LCR circuit. How much voltage we have given? V equal to V naught sin omega t. And what you got? We got the impedance and we got the value of current. Is it clear? Okay, then the question is, what about the phase difference? What about the phase difference of that resultant voltage with the current? Current is not changing. The current is I throughout the circuit. And we should check what's the resultant voltage. See the diagram here. So I call this is the resultant voltage. This is the current. This is the resultant voltage. The angle between these two is pi. Okay. So voltage and current angle is pi. Right. So how to get the pi value? This is opposite side and this is adjacent side. I can take the tan pi to get phase difference. Phase difference between the resultant voltage. Resultant means final voltage. Resultant voltage and current. I'll take this as the pi. So now here this is tan pi. Tan pi is equal to opposite side. So opposite side in Akta, this is the AB. AB indicating VL minus VC. This is VL minus VC divided by, see the diagram. Next, adjacent side. Adjacent side is this one. It is nothing but VR. This is nothing but VR. So this is the value of tan pi. Okay, so I'll continue here. Tan pi equal to VL minus VC by R. I know the value of VL. I know the value of VC and also I know the value of IR. So this is also okay. You can write like tan pi is equal to VL minus VC divided by R. Pi equal to tan inverse of that value. Pi equal to tan inverse of VL minus VC by R. So I can still extend it. Okay. So tan pi is equal to I into, okay. So what's a VL? VL means I into XL, VC, I into XC divided by VR. VR means I into R. See here, in the numerator I is common and denominator is one more I get cancelled. So tan pi is equal to XL minus XC divided by R. Inductive reactance minus capacitive reactance divided by the resistance of the resistor. Okay, then pi is equal to tan inverse of XL minus XC divided by R. tan inverse of XL minus XC divided by R. You can write tan inverse of VL minus VC by R. Okay, so this is the phase difference between the voltage and current. Phase difference between voltage and current in a series LCR circuit. So this is a very important derivation. I think so. From this topic only there are 2-5 mass questions. Okay, one is for the series LCR circuit. So another one is maybe LC oscillator or any one of the capacitor inductor. Is it okay? It's a very important. So ee topic alli previous question per nodidrandre ondu theory 5 mass bartada illa athu problems ide concept melle problems varabodu. So if you know the theory you can solve the problem. So it's a very important one. So you can note the thing now. This is the circuit, this is the phasor diagram. First I should explain, consider an inductor, capacitor and resistor in series. You should write the first sentence connected to AC. Consider inductor, capacitor and series connected in series with the AC circuit. The latter you should mention as it is. Okay, you can note it. Next one, electrical resonance. So the given LCR circuit, is said to be at resonance. When the maximum current flows through it. Okay. So the given circuit, this given LCR circuit is said to be at resonance if the maximum current flows through it. So this is called electrical resistance. And then the next question rises: when it can allow the maximum current to flow through it? It's very simple. Logically, whenever the resistance is low, I shouldn't use the word resistance here. So if it is resistance, means it's a conductor or resistor. Here the word is impedance. Whenever there is a lower opposition, there must be the maximum current. Okay, and we have derived the expression for impedance and the current, everything. So what's the equation for the impedance? So z equal to under square r square plus XL minus XC whole square. This is the effective resistance. You can say effective opposition, or you can say impedance. If this value is lesser, so then the I will be maximum, because I is equal to V by Z. If this decrease and this will increase, is it okay? So then how to minimize that impedance? So we can't alter the R value, X value, XC value once you have choose that component. Okay, so better we should take select components like this. We should take the inductor. See, you can't take R equal to 0, because if it is a resistor, it must show you some resistance. In ideal case, inductor having the zero resistance. Okay, in ideal case, but in fact it is also having some resistance, opposition. So that is XL. You can't zero the XC. But what we can do? We can do XL equal to XC. If you choose such a case, then Z value is R square plus this term becomes zero. Okay, so this will be Z equal to R. See, compare this equation and this equation. Here you are having the minimum opposition. That opposition is equal to opposition offered by the resistor only. There is no opposition by the inductor as well as the capacitor. No opposition by the inductor as well as capacitor. Only opposition is by our resistor. Is it clear? Okay, this is the case where you can get the maximum current, where you can get the I maximum. Right? So when do you say the circuit is at resonance? When the circuit is allowing the maximum current, then we say it is at electrical resonance. Then how we can achieve that electrical resonance? So by making XL equal to XC, we can achieve the electrical resonance. You may get a one mark question. What is the condition for electrical resonance? Or you can get a question like, what's the condition to get the maximum current in the LCR circuit? So you should mention XL equal to XC, like a inductive reactance equal to capacitive reactance. is it? And see, inductive reactance, capacitive reactance, they may become equal on the basis of their frequencies, on the basis of the frequency of applied AC. So what's that? So if XL equal to, if XL equal to XC, for XL I can write, for XL I can write omega into L, for XC I can write 1 by omega into C. Omega value is 2 pi f, 2 phi into root of 2 pi f and L as it is. So 1 divided by omega is 2 pi f and this is the C, 2 pi fl and 2 pi fc. So now this 2, okay, so then you can't cancel it like a 2 pi by 2 pi, okay. So here L and C, I take L and C here and the remaining term is 2 pi into 2 pi, so 4 pi square, okay, 4 pi square into f, 4 pi square into, sorry, 4 pi square into f. So you have to keep the f here only, so f into one more f, this is f square, and here this will be f into f, f square, 2 pi l, l and 2 pi c, okay. F square is equal to, f square is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi square l into c. I can write f is equal to, f is equal to, so 2 pi, so this is 1 and I can take a square root, 4 pi square is 2 pi under root L into C. So this is the equation for resonant frequency. So we call this as a resonant frequency. If our frequency is this much value, if our frequency is this much value, then you can attain XL equal to XC. If XL equal to XC, then there is a possibility of resonance. So that's why we call this frequency as a resonant frequency, or we can equate it here only like a omega square equal to 1 by LC, omega square equal to LC, then omega equal to 1 by root of LC. So if you want to write it in terms of angular frequency or angular velocity, that will be 1 divided by root of LC. In terms of the frequency, that will be, so omega is 2 pi f, so take this 2 pi here, so f equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of LC. So this is called the resonant frequency. So you may get a one mass question, what is the resonant frequency? The frequency at which, the frequency at which the current is maximum in series LCR circuit. The frequency at which the current is maximum in series LCR circuit, that is called the resonant frequency. Okay, and what is the condition for resonance? XL equal to XC. Is it? So it is about the electrical resonance and resonant frequency. Next one is sharpness of resonance and Q factor. So if you draw the graph of the current versus the frequency for that series LCR circuit, so we should just start to change the frequency. So as a result, there will be change in the XL and XC. As a result, there will be change in impedance. As a result, there will be change in the current. So this is the independent factor, frequency. Either base mill in actada, current decide actada. Okay, and we know at a particular frequency there will be the maximum current. Okay, we have drawn the graph. Okay, at a particular frequency there is a maximum current. For that maximum current we call the I naught. We call I naught. Okay, I want to get its RMS value. So the RMS value, I RMS is equal to I naught divided by square root of 2. Okay, so I naught root 2. Okay, or we can write 0.414 of I naught. 0.414 times the I naught. And if you know the I naught value, so I can get the value of I naught by root 2. So I take this as I naught by root 2 symbolically. I naught by root 2 this is. So if I extend this one, so there will be intersection of that graph. Okay. If I join it here, I call this as a frequency omega 1 and this as a frequency omega 2. So what's the value of current in case of omega and omega 2? In both the cases, you are having the same current, that is I naught by root 2. Okay, for a single current, we are having the two frequencies, either the omega 1 or omega 2. Okay, so I can write this omega 1. I can write this omega 1 as omega naught minus delta omega. Okay, so totally this is a omega naught. Omega naught alli ishtu minus madidva naavu. I call this is delta omega. Idu ashtu irthadano, idu ashtu irthada. Omega naught minus delta omega, we will get the omega 1. And how to write the omega 2? So this is omega naught. If you add this delta omega, we will get omega 2. Is it? Now this difference omega 2 minus omega 1 is equal to omega naught plus delta omega minus omega naught minus delta omega. Now this omega plus omega minus omega cancel. So omega 2 minus omega 1. So this will be 2 times the delta omega. 2 times the delta omega. This one. So this one. So for this region, so for this frequencies, we call the bandwidth. We call it as a bandwidth. Therefore, bandwidth equal to omega 2 minus omega 1. Omega 2 minus omega 1 is equal to 2 times the delta omega. So this is our bandwidth for that given LCR circuit. Is it? Okay. Next, the question is about what's a Q factor? See, a Q factor means is a quality factor that decides the resonance. If the resonance of that curve, if the resonance curve is sharper, the quality is better. If the resonance is wider, the graph is wider, so the quality is lower. Okay, so that's why the formula for Q factor is omega naught divided by bandwidth, or you can write resonant frequency divided by bandwidth. So if the bandwidth is more, the quality factor is lesser. If the quality factor is lesser, the sharpness is lesser. So I can write Q is equal to resonant frequency is omega naught and bandwidth is 2 times the delta omega. So this is called the quality factor. The quality factor decides the sharpness. If the sharpness is better, so il baal sharp agittu bandwidth kadime irthada. Bandwidth kadime itto Q factor jaasti irthada. Okay, or we can also write this Q factor in terms of the voltage in the inductor, so VL by V, or we can also write it as VC divided by V. So idu yavaga andre at resonance case. Okay, at resonance case, if you have taken the ratio of potential in the inductor to the total potential, or if you have taken the ratio of potential in the capacitor to the total potential, you will get a quantity that is called the Q factor, and this is only in case of resonance. Okay, so this is called the Q factor. So Q factor decides the sharpness. Okay, if the sharpness means is sharp baal sharp itto quality factor quantity chalo irthada jaasti irthada, is it?